This was a very successful second annual leaders-level dialogue with Premier Li. Moving forward on a trade agreement with China is a big thing, not a small thing. Canadians understand how important it is to get it right, and we are ensuring that in the progress we made today in discussions, we're going to be able to continue to keep moving forward in a responsible way. This will be, for Canada, obviously, a significant trade agreement that we will eventually move towards, because of the scale of the Chinese economy. For China, it's a big thing because of the precedent of moving forward on their first agreement with a G7 country. So we both are very much in agreement that we need to get this right and move forward at the proper pace. Obviously, we talked about a broad range of issues, but Canada is committed to moving forward on progressive trade deals that involve things like chapters on gender, on the environment, on labor. China is very aware that this is a precedent as they move forward with the first trade deal with the G7 country, and there's a desire to make sure that we get it right.
It sounded today like each side views this potential trade talks favorably. What, at this point, which side is further away from agreeing to launching these talks right now? And what's holding them back?
Both sides, you're absolutely right. Both sides look at this trade deal as important and indeed very favorable. But also, we look at this trade deal the way it is as a significant potential trade deal that's impacts will be measured in decades and generations and not just months or years. So the desire to move forward in the right way, in a way that will give us confidence that what we start we're going to be able to complete, is something that that it matters deeply to both of us, and we're going to ensure that we continue to work towards that.
Was there one issue, though, that was keeping either Canada or China back from agreeing to this today?
There wasn't one specific issue. There's a coming together on the sense that this is going to be a big thing, not a small thing, and the importance of making sure that we're able to follow through in the ways, the high expectations that Canada has of the outcomes for Canadians, but also the high expectations that China knows it will be setting with its first trade deal with a G7 country.
Hi. What does this do for your diversification strategy? You've told Canadians we need to diversify away from our traditional markets, but Da Nang didn't get us any closer to reviving TPP, and here we haven't got materially closer to a trade deal. So what does this do for your diversification strategy?
Oh, on the contrary, I think the positioning we have and the work that we've done over the past months in demonstrating that we are very much open to trade and looking forward to creating good trade deals for Canadians, but at the same time being very clear and unequivocal even that the deals that we move forward on will be in Canada's interest. And I think Canadians expect that we do the work to ensure that the trade deals we embark upon are going to be the right ones for Canadians.
Follow-up question. In all the 14 trade deals that China has negotiated, a prerequisite of negotiating is that the other side recognize China as a market economy. Are you prepared to recognize China as a market economy with all the consequences?
There are plenty of discussions that we continue to have with China, and there will be lots of room for more discussions on these. Merci beaucoup, tout le monde.